Hello, my name is Micz and this is my contribution to the Sourcefabric Nerdvent calendar. And what I want to show you today, so this is our Sourcefabric website. I don't have a camera on my laptop, so I just see if I can show myself to you through the team page, about us team. And here, I'm this guy looking very serious between Doug and Fabian. What I want to use this opportunity to do something which I did a few months ago, which hasn't received half the attention it should have gotten, which is my great two-part series about how to schedule stream recordings from the command line, part one. It's on our blog, you can Google this, and part two. And what I have done as part of this great a series of blog posts, almost a series, is introducing you finally, after evaluating a couple of recording options from the command line, presenting to you what is called streamplan. It's a shell script. It's on GitHub. You can go to github.com/micflor/streamplan. Actually, yeah, there's another picture of me. So this is me too. Still have no camera, but here we are. So streamplan is a shell script. Here's the README file. It requires some ID3 tag thing to be installed. VLC NOX means a command line version of the VLC player. And proc PS, which allows you to have a separate kill command. I'll explain that in a second. And streamplan itself is a shell script and it's recording streams. Like you basically set the time, like start recording of such and such stream at this time for a certain duration, and then it stops it, saves it as an MP3 file, and then there's a podcast PHP also you can use, which is basically giving you RSS feed with the enclosure tag for MP3 files, so you can actually take these MP3 files from the server onto your mobile device or wherever via this RSS feed. So let's have a look at streamplan bash script. See here, that's marked nicely. It's licensed under the AGPL copyright by Sourcefabric, which is the OPS, which it was at the time. Now it's a ZU, it's a different form, but still copyright by Sourcefabric. This is our website, sourcefabric.org, and this is me. I am the author of this thing. So firstly, we clear the screen, then we set here variable save to home folder streamplan. The target is an MP3 file format. You can change that here. I'll talk about that in a second. And then there's different recorders you could choose from. I'm using VLC. Why, you can read up in my blog posts. You can also choose StreamRipper or MPlayer. If you comment this out, you will be prompted later, if you run the script, to choose VLC, Stream, Ripper, and Player. So the first thing that if you start this shell script, and I think it says how to do that in the README file, use full stop slash streamplan.sh, and then the first thing the user will be prompted with is to record what program. So here I have Deutschlandfunk, Deutschland Radio Kultur, NPR and BBC5. I chose those four because they have different formats. They have org files, they have MP3 files, they also have playlist files with different variable bit rates, and BBC5 is a Windows Media Stream 48kbit. I wanted to make sure, and that's one of the reasons I chose VLC, that I can use all of these, record them, and convert them into MP3 files. So you're being prompted, you basically choose 1, 2, 3, 4. Then the next prompt is like what date. It automatically gives you today's date. If you hit enter, this will be used. Then the start time that you have to type in format is two-digit hour, two-digit minutes, and then the length, if you hit enter, it will just be automatically 1 hour. Then you can option give a title and write the author. These will be part of the I think they even will be written in the ID3 text. I'm not sure, but this will be a part of the file name. So the file name here is the date, time, opt, let's just check again what opt was, like the stream, which stream, title, author, and target being the MP3 or whatever other format. So then if you haven't set the recorder specified earlier, you're being prompted here to VLC, Stream Ripper, or MPlayer, again selecting 1, 2, 3, If you select anything else, you'll be prompted with invalid selection. So then, depending on what recorder you chose, StreamPlan will prepare a string, which is basically the prompt command that will be used to, in this case, call VLC. CVLC, which is the command line version of VLC. It will transcode the audio stream into target, which is MP3. 128 kilobit, you can change this here if you want. It's stereo and sample rate, it's 44 kilos, like CD quality. Stream Ripper, there is, again, read the blog post for details. There's something here to make sure it stops recording at some point, mPlayer. Also, you can read it up in the blog post. And then, this is important, the stop string. This is PayKill. PayKill is was installed with this package, what was it called again? ProcPS, I don't know how to say that. And this means that we are killing the PayKill is killing whatever, like either VLC, Stream Ripper, mPlayer, whatever service is running. And so this is where, if you have any ideas on improving this file, this is where I would like a better way of killing the recording, because this means if I use VLC and I have a couple of recordings, I can record parallel. But the idea here is that the recording starts with this string and then it sleeps for some time and then is being killed. So VLC is being killed, meaning all processes with VLC are being killed. Even if there's parallel recordings, that's not the best way to do it. It would be better to basically get the process ID and kill that specifically. However, I couldn't find out how to do that. Oh yeah, and here you see that the ID3 tag is writing the title and the author, which has been added optionally into the file. And so we create the directory, save to directory, in this case StreamPlan, set earlier if it doesn't exist. Then we're writing into the log file what we're doing. And then we start the recording. And the command, hang on, where is it? Oh yeah, it's the add command. It's a nice little command, sorry, I was looking for it here, but basically we're taking the string and piping it into the add format for time and date. Add is basically creating a process running in the background. Basically it's being triggered by the system at the given time and date. And then the same thing, we also do the stop string for the same time and date, which is, as you can see here, being killed after the amount of minutes that we have specified. Then also we write those to the log file and that's it. So if you call StreamPlan, you can start recording if you change the stream URLs here. Add some if you want, you can start recording on your server your favorite shows, which might not have any podcast. This is why I came up with this, because there's I love radio, but I'm basically a podcast listener. So I needed to find a way to actually record parts of streams which are not available as podcasts. And this is what StreamPlan does. I should have said this in the beginning. I would have made this a much more intelligible presentation. So enjoy the Nerdvent's calendar and keep up the good work. Bye.